Good morning, everybody. This is Ryan Alexander with Denison Yachting. Today, I am in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, where I'm going to be taking you on a walkthrough of motor yacht KHALEESI. She is an 80-foot Hatteras motor yacht built in 2013. This turnkey Hatteras motor yacht is listed centrally for sale with Denison broker David Johnson. I really like this boat a lot. Reason is, she's really beamy. You've got a full beam salon, a full beam master, and three other staterooms. So in terms of layout, that's what really makes this boat special. Before we get going, I'm gonna take the next 30 to 45 seconds, show you some drone footage so you can see what she looks like when she's underway, and then we're gonna get right into it. Today's walkthrough has us starting up on the tender deck, just one of the several overbuilt areas making this yacht capable of both entertaining and transporting. We first see a single Sea-Doo spark, but this area is actually equipped to store and transport two personal watercraft. These are held in place by removable chocks bolted to the deck. To starboard is the Marquip davit that deploys the wave runners. As you can see, the wave runner is being lowered down, and you can see the roof of a larger structure. Another upside of this yacht is that she's stored inside of this shed to keep her in great shape. Forward and to port on the tender deck are a pair of electric grills for those weekends when you're entertaining on the hook or under the stars. You also see that there are speakers overhead mounted into the hardtop. Looking up in centerline, we next notice the radar mast equipped with a KVH TrackVision HD7 Sat TV antenna and a KVH TrackPhone V3 satellite phone receiver. In addition, we see a Garmin open array 72-mile radar and a Garmin XM satellite antenna. Next, we step forward from the tender deck and into the open bridge layout of the flybridge with a full sea acrylic curtain enclosure. In addition to being spacious and fully loaded, the flybridge is air conditioned and has teak flooring throughout the entire sole. Looking to the port side, we first see a radial settee that serves as a perfect spot to sit down with a great book. To help with the mood in here, note the integrated sound system found throughout. Right next to the seating area is a TV that's tied into the speaker system that I just mentioned. Forward of this is the flybridge wet bar. The countertop is made of flawless matte finished teak. Around the outside edge are three bar stools, and behind the bar, there's a sink, a refrigerator, and an ice maker. Over on the starboard side, we see a ton of seating that runs just about the entire length of the flybridge, with the aft section being part of a large alfresco dinette. Forward of this long built-in settee is a sliding door that gives you quick access down into the galley. This brings us to the yacht's primary helm, with seating for captain and mate with twin white leather Platinum Series pompanette helm seats. From these upgraded seats, your captain has control of dual Garmin 15-inch 7215 chart plotter touchscreens with an NEC Hatteras ship system computer in between. Outboard into port are two ICOM M604 VHF radios. Directly below are backup engine controls, right next to a pair of ACR searchlight controls. And then beyond, there's a control pad for KHALEESI's zero-speed stabilizers. Directly in front of the ship's polished wheel is the control for the autopilot and the bow thruster joystick, as well as engine controls over on the starboard side. Jumping from one side of the yachting experience to another brings us to the swim platform, an area ripe for Caribbean escapes. Found along the aft are five removable safety stanchions. When removed, you have a non-skid finished swim platform where you can swim at night illuminated by 6 Aqualuma underwater lights. This Euro transom has port and starboard steps that have upgraded teak treads. And over by the port staircase, there's a freshwater shower. Now we're going to take a look on the other side of her watertight transom door. The cruise space on KHALEESI features an upgraded and customized dinette and common area that's part of a custom 2-stateroom arrangement. Opposite the dinette to port is a wall-mounted 19-inch LED TV and storage with the entrance to the crew head aft. Forward on the starboard side is the first crew cabin with a full-sized berth. Looking just outside of this cabin, we see the crew kitchenette that has a microwave above eye level and a refrigerator beneath the countertop. The second crew cabin is on the port side with 2 twin-sized berths in a bunk configuration. Immediately forward of the crew space is KHALEESI's captain-maintained engine room. This is where her twin Caterpillar C32A certs show their might. Each engine puts out 1,600 horsepower of reliable power, with all services being up to date. To port and starboard are twin Cummins Onan 27.5 kilowatt generators that power the house when you're away from the dock. Just forward of the port generator is a Sea Recovery 1,400 gallon a day water maker with a spot zero in line with the water maker itself. A handy upgrade found down here are the washer and dryer found aft of the engines, serving as one of 2 laundry centers on board. Finally, overhead, there are 3 Raymarine engine room cameras, keeping the captain in the know when going through routine checks and when underway. It's not just the mechanical spaces. This entire yacht is captain maintained daily and ready for immediate inspection and delivery. Her next owner can have the confidence that comes with the Hatteras pedigree of being a world-class yacht. Whether cruising at 14 knots or running at a top speed of around 20 knots, this 80-footer offers a dreamy ride that's been upgraded with zero-speed stabilizers, and she also has a hydraulic bow thruster. A popular space for your guests to hang out and gather is the aft deck, which is protected from the elements and maxed out with upgrades. First, we have the dinette aft and centerline with bench seating built into the transom. The seating is on all sides of a matte finished teak table with an upgraded varnished teak cap rail running along the aft. Forward on the starboard side is an all-important wing station offering full control over the yacht when backing into your slip. Directly above this aft helm is a fold-down 20-inch LED TV in the molded overhead. Also seen in the overhead is LED lighting, 2 Ghost mini-dome cameras, and JL audio speakers tied in with the salon's Bose sound system for those nights when you're hosting. Located both port and starboard are side boarding gates, and just forward of the port gate is a lighted staircase with teak treads that leads up to the tender deck. Below this staircase and behind a door, we see another stairwell that leads down to the crew quarters and engine room. From the aft deck, we next pass through large stainless half-moon sliding doors and into this 80-footer's salon. Taking up the nearly 21-foot 3-inch beam of the yacht is the primary indoor lounging space that's finished with a cherry satin millwork package. Keeping the warm feel in here is a natural toned carpet underfoot and LED lighting on a dimmer up in the overhead. We're going to start breaking down this space on the starboard side, where we first see a great upgrade, a sunken wet bar equipped with a sink, refrigeration, and an ice maker. Above the bar is a 42-inch TV that's connected to a Bose Link sound system with 5-zone party mode for nights that you have guests on board. Another great feature I want to touch on is the Paradox Insight security and monitoring system that allows you to control most of the boat's electrical systems and provides you assurance that you're secure. Now looking immediately forward of the wet bar, we see a sitting area below a long row of tinted windows that run the length of the salon. Here, 2 armchairs are separated by a small table with a reading lamp. Looking to the opposite side of the salon and aft, we have the lounging area with an L-shaped sofa and an armchair, both of which share an ottoman. Directly forward of the sofa is the yacht's formal dining space with a custom china cabinet located just forward of it. Heading further towards the bow from here brings us into the galley, but we're going to stick to the starboard side where we next arrive at the main deck dayhead. This brings us to a set of stairs just forward of the dayhead that lead down into the lower companionway, where we arrive at the guest accommodations. We're going to start aft in the master. The owner's suite has a king-sized berth in the center of the space with nightstands to either side. Part of what makes this space calming is the padded headboard and the sound-deadening carpet that double down on the feeling of being in an oasis. Looking over to starboard, we see the first of two dressers with drawer storage. These are on both sides of the master. These storage banquettes are located below three large portholes in the hull that light this space up and give you a great view just above the waterline. The master also provides additional storage in a pair of cedar-lined closets with double door entries. On the forward bulkhead, we see a 42-inch LED TV that's part of the yacht's Crestron Prodigy Media Center, assuring that you always have something to entertain your guests. A great feature of the master onboard KHALEESI is the optional his and hers head layout of the ensuite. Both vanities in here have countertops in Calcutta gold with under-mounted sinks. The hers side to port also has a dressing station. Separating the two sides of the ensuite is a marble shower stall with glass walls offering a spa-level experience. Leaving here, just a few steps outside of the master is the yacht's second laundry center with a stacked washer and dryer. Our next stop is forward into the port in the companionway, the port side VIP. This cabin has a queen berth with dresser storage outboard below a hull window. Just forward of the dresser, there's a cedar-lined hanging locker. Turning our attention to the forward bulkhead, we see a 32-inch LED TV that's outside of the entrance into the cabin's ensuite. When we cross the companionway, we're brought into a guest cabin with transverse twin berths. There's a hanging locker below the upper bunk with a safe, something that you find in every cabin. In the corner opposite the berth is a 19-inch TV, which is just outside of the entrance into the ensuite. Immediately outside of this cabin is where we come across the crux of the yacht's AV system, where we see the brain of the KVH systems and seven direct TV receivers. The fourth and final stateroom is the bow VIP with a queen-sized berth. There's airline-style storage that flanks the berth and cedar-lined hanging lockers to port and starboard. Looking to the aft bulkhead, we see this cabin's 32-inch TV and Bose LS-235 sound system. Like the other cabins, the bow VIP has a private ensuite with a shower stall. From here, let's pick back up where we left off on the main deck and enter KHALEESI's highly functional galley. This is a space where you have to give Hatteras credit for making so much happen in one place. You have plenty of countertop area, storage, and a dinette, all while remaining uncluttered. The upgraded Amtico flooring in here is also a great touch due to the high traffic nature of this space. The galley is laid out around an island with a durable stone countertop that's right next to a temporary deep freezer. The absolute black countertops are also found outside of the island near the cooking appliances. These are made up of an overhead microwave, and just below is a four-burner ceramic cooktop just above an oven. Looking to the starboard side, we see the galley's stand-up refrigerator and freezer that's just forward of a staircase which leads up to the flybridge. The remaining appliances in the galley are the dual Sub-Zero refrigerators with pull drawers found just below the 32-inch LED TV forward on the port side. Rounding out this space, we see an elevated dinette with L-shaped seating and a stone countertop. And then to both port and starboard in the galley, there are side deck access doors, both of which give the crew and guests access to the foredeck, which will be our last stop on today's walkthrough. Enclosing this bow are polished stainless safety rails that speak to the stout and overbuilt feel of the metalwork on this yacht. These grab rails meet all the way forward at the ground tackle. This is where we see her Maxwell 4000 windlass that draws her anchor. Immediately aft of the ground tackle, we see a sun pad level with the deck that serves as a quiet venue to get the day started, coffee in hand. In addition to an upgraded freshwater washdown on the bow, there are also large bosun lockers to port and starboard that offer you a ton of critical storage. On behalf of the entire Denison team, myself, Ryan Alexander, and broker David Johnson, thank you for joining me on today's walkthrough of KHALEESI. If you have any questions about this boat or you'd like to step on board in person, you can reach out to David and set that up anytime.